We are truly blessed. Now, we are blessed inside out. We have now become the children of God, as John chapter 1 verse 12 tells us. And you know, we are so blessed and loved by the Heavenly Father. And this kind of love makes us a blessed people. Now, some of us, because of our circumstances, because of our emotions, we might not be able to accept this fact that we indeed are blessed. So even if we are not seeing it in the natural right now, you know, the way for us to make that seen in the natural is by faith, by understanding who we have become in Christ Jesus, and having faith in that and then living it out. So we are blessed, and this is our spiritual positional reality. Now let's look at the heart of God for the people whom He created. You know, right at the start, when He created Adam and Eve, what did God do? You know, how did God respond? You know, Genesis 1:28, we read that God blessed them and He pronounced over them and said, "Be fruitful and multiply." So God's heart for the people whom He has created is to bless them. So God's heart is a heart that blesses His people. And God never, never wanted His people to not receive this blessing. So this blessedness in Christ Jesus, today I just want to put it in three very, very simple sections. The first one being, in our relationship with God, we have boldness. Because of what God has done for us, in us, we now have boldness in our relationship with God. The second one is that, you know, we can now have hope in our circumstances. The circumstances around us, whatever it is that we are experiencing, because of the blessedness that we have through the Lord Jesus Christ, we can have hope in our circumstances. Third one being that we have overcoming power over Satan and the powers of darkness. Before the redeeming work of the Lord Jesus Christ, before our acceptance of the redeeming work of the Lord Jesus Christ, we were far away from God. We were alienated from God. But now, our blessedness is that we have been brought so near to the living God. And the Word of God, you know, tells us so many things of what Jesus has done on the cross, and how this has changed our position before God. So I'm just going to look at a few things that have happened in us in Christ Jesus. The first one being that we have been forgiven. God has paid the price, or God, in other words, has paid the ransom for you and I to experience that life of forgiveness. The next thing that I just want to take time on is the fact that we have now been justified. This is a free gift of God, but we know that the Lord Jesus paid a huge price for you and me to stand justified in the presence of God. We now have intimacy with God. He is in us, and we are in Him. That is the safest place. That is the safest place, in God. We are loved by God the way the Lord Jesus was loved by God. We are God's beloved. The Father rejoiced in Jesus. The Father celebrated Jesus. And we are being told here that He loves us the way He loved the Lord Jesus Christ. So we are dearly loved by God, and we enjoy this position of being celebrated by God. And you know, let's not forget that God has blessed us in every possible way in the Lord Jesus Christ. And today, as we stand as God's children, we have our significance and our security, which is flowing from who we are in the Lord Jesus Christ and what He has done for us on the cross of Calvary, and we can enter His presence boldly. We can conquer any sin. We can conquer the work of the enemy in any which way coming against us, and we can stand and testify to the victory of God. And that's possible because of what God has done for us.